Well, look, hasn't Albo had an absolute shocking week? First, after saying he's never lost a news poll, well, he did. The coalition now leads Labor two-party preferred for the first time since the 2022 election. And then Albo went to the Copacabana, purchasing a $4.3 million beach house, and then offered up this shocking explanation.
When your relationship changes, your life changes and you make decisions. But what I'm focused on is making sure that everyone can get a roof over their head.
I mean, it's very different situations. He's very, look, I've said this earlier in the week on it. I don't have a problem with him buying a house, right? Yeah. I don't care. All the power to you. Yeah. If you've got the money in the climate, go for it. The problem I have, Tania, is the optics of this. And he keeps saying, oh, but I grew up in state housing. Mm. Well, why don't you do something to help people who are actually in state housing?
Exactly. And it must make so many people angry, those who are paying, you know, mortgages, interest rates have gone up, people who can't enter housing. And as you quite rightly say, those doing it tough that, you know, really do need the help of Department of Housing. And I think everyone is so sick of him using his poor mother and that whole Department of Housing story. But also, what about the poor members of Parliament who are in swing seats, right? I've heard all week in Parliament in New South Wales, Labor MPs just roll their eyes at this and say,
oh, really?
It doesn't help them at all. It doesn't help them at all because it's so arrogant. It is so arrogant. Yes, he can buy a home. We know that he's been working for a long time. He's got money.
Hang on. But working? It's, the taxpayer funded his entire lifestyle.
It's still a job. It's still a job. But nevertheless, it is... you know, he essentially sent a message that his personal needs now outweigh, you know, his colleagues and the concerns they have about the upcoming election and indeed the rest of the, Australia, where people, you know, we've got millions of people
really
can't entering the housing market.
I feel sorry for Dr. Reed, who represents Robinson in that area.
Yeah.
Copacabana. I was on the Central Coast recently. This week, the headlines have been all about that, and they're furious. They're so angry.
Well, he's a marginal seat.
They have baseball bats in Robinson ready for that Dr. Reed, who's quite a decent guy.
Yeah.
But also, if someone in the private sector would be smart enough, if you don't want your name associated with the purchase of a home, they'd have a company or a trust or something.
Yeah.
No, Albanese's clueless. All he knows is take that taxpayer wage for the last how many years, 30 years, whatever. That's all he knows.
I don't think he's clueless, Tina. I think he thinks he can win on a minority government. I think he thinks he can do a deal with the Teals and the Greens.
Oh, God,
and it doesn't matter if he loses a few Labor MPs in the process.
You won't convince me he's not stupid, Tania.
I think he's arrogant.
All of the above.
I wonder if he's just thinking about retirement, maybe. Who knows at this point?